Welcome. I'm Gwendolyn Sterk, and I'm here from Sterk Family Law, and I'm with Seth Matus. Welcome to our office.
Hi there.
Tell everybody what you do.
I'm a labor and employment attorney. I work both for workers and for companies, but I advise in all areas of labor and employment law. And so that goes into all sorts of issues, whether we're talking about discrimination. It can be things like maybe you haven't been paid your appropriate wages or commissions. It can be things like sometimes you're a whistleblower. Sometimes you might be involved in situations with domestic abuse and you want to know about your rights. You can have family leave issues, sick leave. And so I run the gamut. And then when we get into labor law, we're talking about unions.
Very interesting. So today what I wanted to talk about for our clientele that we have out there is the information about what their workplace rights are. You know, we do family law, and so you can understand that that's a transition time for a lot of people, and so they're worried about their job, frankly. You know, they're going through a life crisis, things are coming up, maybe they are returning to the workforce for the first time, maybe they have a disability, they're not sure how to broach these subjects, and it becomes just another layer of trauma for them. And so what I want to do today is kind of unfold different areas that people might want to see or understand with regard to their workplace rights and obligations. You know, I never think you have a right without having an obligation.
Absolutely. That is very true.
So let's talk about, first of all, just the idea of wages. What is the general concept of wage regulation?
Well, first and foremost, you know, you have to have at least the minimum wage paid.
Right.
And in Illinois, at this point, I believe we're up to about $10 an hour. I think it's going up at the start of the year. But beyond that, there's all sorts of issues. I mean, if you are a non-exempt employee, and that means you're not an executive, you're not someone who is like a physician or a high-level person, you're entitled to overtime. Every time you work more than 40 hours a week, you're entitled to time and a half. There can be other things above and beyond that. I mean, there's special rules when you're paid on commissions. There's special rules that are, you know, apply when you get bonuses. And so basically there's a whole area of law which has evolved about just dealing with pay and compensation.
Right. And so if a client or a potential client had a question, they could consult with you to find out whether or not any of their rights or obligations are being violated.
Absolutely.
Is that correct?
Absolutely.
So we get into the area of wages, and then also with regard to employment law, people are very worried about the issue of discrimination in the workplace. Especially, you know, we get a lot of older individuals, and we're seeing the increase in domestic relations cases of the 50 plus community. So people talk about discrimination, especially age discrimination. I've heard more about that recently than in the past. Tell us about the different areas of discrimination and what someone can do about that.
Well, absolutely. In terms of age discrimination, there is both federal, state, and even local law, which applies to protect people who are over 40 years of age.
And so over 40. Oh,
over
my.
40.
I was thinking it could be over 50. Yeah.
No, we're talking 40.
Right.
And
well,
so
apparently I'm old.
Yeah. I'm there too.
Okay.
But basically what happens is that in the event that there's any kind of discrimination, and that doesn't just mean firing. Okay. I mean, if you're, you know, receiving less pay than someone, if, you know, the employer is treating you poorly compared to another person who is younger, that can give rise to claims of age discrimination. I mean, certainly people also have rights when we're talking about race and sex and, you know, all the other things which people think about. I mean, disability can come into play sometimes. So there are actually probably a good 12 to 15 categories which are protected under either federal law, Illinois state law, or local law.
So that would be your wage and income ability, then your ability with regard to discrimination. Tell me about harassment in the workplace. How is that addressed?
Well, harassment is also, it's a subspecies of discrimination.
Okay.
And so what happens with harassment is, I mean, everybody normally thinks about it with sexual harassment.
Sure.
Whether we're talking about Bill Cosby.
That's what we hear in the news, right?
Absolutely, all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, that is a huge area.
Sure.
But another thing which people don't think about as much is that it can happen based upon people's age or harassment, or I'm sorry, age or, you know, disability. Any of those types of protected categories can make claims of harassment when the employer is treating them in a hostile or adverse way because of their protected class.
Okay.
And what ends up happening is you have the same types of rights, you know, if an employer is knowledgeable. An employer will have a policy for harassment, which will protect, you know, provide protection both to the employer and to the employee. But if they don't, employees actually have a right to go to the same types of government agencies that would apply for discrimination, and that would be the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, the Illinois Department of Human Rights.
Okay.
In Chicago, the Cook County Human Rights Commission.
So there are different remedies that they might have available.
Absolutely.
Now let's go to people who are disabled, because are there certain rights in addition to the ADA, the Americans with Disability Act, correct?
There is. I mean, there is certainly the state law, which is the Illinois Human Rights Act. But, you know, what is different with the ADA and any of the other discrimination statutes is that there is a right to accommodation. And that becomes huge with people who have some type of disability. What the ADA requires is that the employer provide some sort of reasonable accommodation to the employee. So if the employee needs, for example, a special kind of desk because they are in a wheelchair, or if they need some type of, you know, they have a vision impairment, they need a reader. Those are the types of things when you can have a reasonable accommodation and the employer can help you work.
And so if somebody needs to have that addressed and it's not being addressed, you could assist them by drafting a letter to the employer before you even engage. So it's not necessarily, if people are fearful, it's not just you can give them guidance about how to do it themselves, or then if that fails to get involved with it as well.
That's right. I mean, sometimes you want to stay out of court, and that's a better way of doing it. So certainly that's what they can do that.
But I think that you can understand where people are coming from in the sense that they are fearful of their jobs because that's their livelihood. And so they want to know what their rights are, but they don't want to rock the boat, so to speak, right?
You know, and that's another interesting point, because there is yet another legal right that people don't think about in that type of situation.
And what is that?
That's called retaliation.
Okay.
And so what retaliation is when you start, you make a complaint, say, about discrimination, you ask for a reasonable accommodation, and rather than getting accommodated, you find that the employer is now treating you worse.
And then maybe even firing you.
That's correct. Right. Well, that actually can give rise to what they call retaliation, and you get the same rights that you would have for a claim of discrimination.
Got it. And so overall, I think that people also have to balance those rights, though, also against what the employer's obligations are.
Yes.
You know, I mean, when you talk about a reasonable accommodation, it doesn't mean that I have to get you the Cadillac model of everything. It has to be reasonable within the framework.
It has to be reasonable.
Right.
And, you know, what they also talk about with accommodation is that there needs to be some sort of give and take dialogue.
Okay.
The employee can't just say, I need this and that's all I'm going to take.
Right.
If the employer comes back and there's something which is going to allow the employee to do their job, even if it's not going to be the full Cadillac, that is something which is sufficient.
Now let's talk about, you're going through a divorce, somebody issues a subpoena and they're asking for not just your employment records, not your income records, but they're asking for your personnel file. Is that protected or is that subpoenable?
That is something which gets very tricky.
Sure.
And actually, most of the time, no, they cannot. There needs to be, that's something which is called the Illinois Personnel Records Review Law.
Okay.
And before they have any type of third party type of subpoena or other opportunity to view your records, it needs to be tied to something in that case.
Okay, I mean, so for example, income. Income would be appropriate for child support or maintenance purposes.
Yes.
Retirement benefits would be relevant. Medical insurance would be relevant, but not necessarily the employment records unless there's some reason for it.
Yes.
So you can contest that and you can know their rights. That's correct.
Exactly.
Well, overall, I think it's important. I think that people are in the workplace, they're fearful. They need to know what their obligations are. And so you heard at the beginning, Seth is here to be available. We're here to talk to you about what your rights are with regard to the subpoena power during the family law process. And Seth, give them your phone number.
My phone number is area code 630-470-6875. You can also see my website. It's www.matuslawoffice. So that's matuslawoffice.com.
Well, thanks for listening today, and I hope you learned something. And if you have to have information, remember that that's what we're here for. Give us a call.
Thank you.